So I'm going to give you a word of the day. I'm going to tell you the meaning and then you'll make the sentence. Okay. Just a second. Can you see something on the screen, the whiteboard?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so the word today is grizzly. Grizzly. Okay. Does anyone know the meaning of this word? Grizzly. Grizzly means causing horror or intense fear. Okay. Grizzly means causing horror or intense fear. So, for example, it was the terrifying monsters that led to the grizzly scenes in the horror movie I watched yesterday. Okay, the meaning is clear to everyone? Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, now make
Yes, ma'am.
Now make a sentence, everyone.
Ma'am, is this an adjective?
Yeah, it's an adjective. Raise your hands when you've made the sentence. Okay, yes, tell me now. Have made the sentence. Okay, Aishwarya, tell me a sentence.
Mom, still making one.
Okay, Arif. Very good. Very good. Manav, sentence.
From the haunted house presented various grisly sights.
Very good. Very good. Short and perfect. Good. Yes, Kanak.
Can someone convince Ananya to get the grizzly mask off her face?
Grizzly mask. Okay. Halloween vibes. Okay. Yes, Aishwarya.
The detective was shocked by the grizzly murder.
Very good. Anyone else? Dishita?
Ma'am, the creepy old man with the grizzly beard stared at me at the bookshop.
Very good. Very good. Okay, now some idioms, okay? Okay, so the first idiom is, it's an easy one, to have a bigger fish to fry. To have a bigger fish to fry. What is the meaning of this? Very good. To have more important or more interesting things to attend to. Okay. To have more important or more interesting things. Very simple sentence. I couldn't help my friend yesterday as I had bigger fish to fry. Okay. Now make sentence. Make a sentence. Bhavya. Sentence. Manshika.
I am preparing for the event that has bigger fish to fry.
Okay, I'm preparing for the event as it is a bigger fish to fry. Okay, Bhavya, yes.
Are you afraid of class 11th? Buddy, you have a bigger fish to fry till the end of your schooling.
Okay. Okay, nice. Okay, Gautam.
Couldn't watch the movie last night because I had a bigger fish to fly.
Okay, very good. Aryan, sentence.
Yes, ma'am. I couldn't play football because I had a bigger fish to fry.
Okay, very good. Next. Next idiom is. Okay, yes, Kanak.
I didn't take the job seriously because I had a bigger fish to fry.
Very good. Very good. Next idiom is from soup to nuts. From soup to nuts means like that includes everything, like from beginning to end. Okay, just a second. Okay. One example, Amazon started out as a bookseller, but now they offer everything from soup to nuts. Okay, meaning clear? Yes, Harav.
Ma'am.
Can you repeat? Okay, very good. Yes, Aishwarya.
Ma'am, it's soup to nuts.
From soup to nuts, yeah?
I'm Arav said fruits to nuts.
From soup to... What did you say, Arav? No, it's not fruits. It's soup. Soup. Okay. Aishwarya? Okay. Yes, Aryan.
Ma'am, to pass the exam, you have to study from soup to nuts, sir.
Very good. To pass the exam, you have to study from soup to nuts. Very good. Kanak.
I'm again.
Okay. Sayam, sentence. Siddharth? Yes, Kanak.
Yes, ma'am.
Make a sentence with this. Kanak, first you say.
Ma'am, to become a cardio doctor, you must know soup to nuts.
Become a cardio doctor, you must know from soup to nuts. Okay. Himanshu? Very good, Kanak. Yes, Himanshu.
Ma'am, you can sell anything from soup to nuts, but not anyone does it well.
Okay, good. Yes, Aishwarya.
I tried everything from soup to nuts to find a lead.
To find a?
A lead.
Lead, okay. Bhavya.
I know my friend from soup to nuts.
I know my friend from soup to nuts. I know about my friend from soup to nuts. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Anyone else?
From soup.
Can you repeat? My voice is breaking.
Ma'am, I know about this area. From soup to nuts.
Very good. Okay. Anyone else?
Okay. Teachers have decided to take a test from soup to nuts till the end of the year.
Till the end of the year. Okay, very good. Next is egg on your face. Egg on your face. This means to look foolish.
You prepared for chemistry in physics exam. It's like you have an egg on your face.
You have eggs on your face. Yeah, very good. Fred had egg on his face after claiming he could climb the tree, but then having to give up. Okay, Shashwat, you have not made a sentence yet. Make one. Egg on your face.
Ma'am, please give me a minute.
Okay. So this is the last one.
Can you give a use of this in a sentence?
Okay. Fred had egg on his face after claiming he could climb the tree but then having to give up. So he had egg on his face. Yes, Harav. Okay, good one. Good. Yes, Arjun.
Yes, ma'am.
Or bola nahi tha
ma'am, the sentence is when my when my girlfriend held my hand in front of everyone, I felt an egg on my face.
That is you. I guess you have done that. Confuse the two words. Egg on your face is basically when you... Okay. Okay, I'll take that as a sentence.
Then I made my sentence.
Yes, tell me.
His Halloween costume really made him look like he had an egg on his face.
His Halloween costume. Okay. Good. Anyone else? Kanak, do you have a sentence?
No, ma'am.
Okay. Yes, Aishwarya.
The couple had an egg on their face after their friends pulled their leg at the party.
Very good. So basically, you use two idioms in one sentence. Very good. Yes, Vanshika.
You can have egg on your face if you make decision without thinking.
If you make decisions without thinking. Very good. Okay. Let's move on to the chapter now.
Yes,
one
more sentence.
Yes, Aryan.
Ma'am, when we were boasting about our win in our match, when we lost, we had an egg on our face.
Okay. After we lost the match, we had egg on our face. Okay. Good, everyone. Good work. Make sure you've written these in your notebook. I'll still send this in the group once. Okay. So make sure you have noted down this in your notebook. Okay. Moving on to the chapter. First, tell me this. This earth. An ailing planet. Give reasons. Okay, tell me this. Is Earth an ailing planet? Give reasons. Raise your hands. I want everyone to answer. We have already done this part.
Ma'am, can you repeat the question?
Is Earth an ailing planet? Give reasons. Okay, good. Raise your hands. Yes, Arif. Very good. Okay, will you do the environment? This is okay. Okay. How do I make sure that this note always comes in like smaller size? Okay, Vanshika.
Yes, Earth is an ailing planet as it is suffering due to global warming and climate change.
Okay, global warming and climate change. Okay. More reasons? Anyone else? Why do you think Earth is an ailing planet? Or how do you think Earth is ailing? Agnish?
Amir?
Yes, tell me.
Ma'am, the human activities have led to global warming, which is making the existing species extinct.
Okay.
And endangering
the species, all the living species.
Ma'am, endangering the biosphere and the ecosystem.
Biological systems. Extinction of many
species. Ma'am, you have exploited the maximum resources available on Earth, which has affected both humans and other species.
Okay. Exploitation of human resources. Just a second. Okay, exploitation of natural resources. Okay, Kanak said that human activities have led to extinction of many species and global warming. Human activities like
I'm excessive use of vehicles and air conditioners and CFCs in the environment.
Okay. Someone said deforestation also. Good point. Any other human activity?
Ma'am, overpopulation.
Carbon emission.
Killing animals.
Carbon emissions. Overpopulation, very good. Killing of animals. Very good. Any other point I'm missing here?
Burning of fossil fuels.
Overcropping.
Poaching. Ma'am, poaching and come under killing only.
Comes in that category only. Very good. Any other sign that makes you think that Earth is an ailing planet?
Ozone layer depletion.
Ozone layer depletion, very good.
Excessive use of plastic.
Okay.
Ma'am, Vanshika's point can come under polluting the environment.
Yeah. What was the point? Vanshika, can you repeat?
Excessive use of plastic or non-biodegradable.
Okay. Acid rain. Can I include acid rain in this? Melting glaciers. Just a second, something happened to the screen. Just a second. Okay, I'll include in this. Acid rain. Melting of glaciers. Okay, we have exploitation of natural resources, ozone layer depletion, everything. Yeah. Okay, that's it. So now, according to all of this, we know that Earth is an ailing planet, right? Okay, now. What is sustainable development? Yes,
Okay.
Can you repeat?
Development that takes place, keeping in mind the needs of the future generation and without harming the environment.
Okay, very good. Very good. Now, why do you think that, why do we compare this article by Nani Palkhiwala to what Copernicus did? Why are we comparing this article that we just read, that we are reading, to what Copernicus did? Yes, Vanshika. Copernicus.
Ma'am, because this article taught about, or ma'am, this article is about, ma'am, spreading awareness as Copernicus did.
Very good. So basically what Copernicus did was to... Yes, Kanak.
Ma'am, because Copernicus taught us that there were several planets revolving around the sun, which changed our whole perspective about the way we saw the universe. And similarly, this article spreads awareness amongst us among us about the changing planet and the harms to it. So this will change our perspective towards it.
Very good. And basically the intensity of the two theories, intensity of both theories and both the articles, is that it is not limited to one person or one country. It is for the entire humankind or entire mankind to become aware of a particular thing. Okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. When was green movement started and where? When was green movement started and where?
1972, New Zealand.
Very good. Very good. Any doubt till now? Okay, moving on. Mr. Lester R. Brown, in his thoughtful book, The Global Economic Prospect, points out that the Earth's principal biological systems are four: fisheries, forests, grasslands, and croplands. And they form the foundation of the global economic system. In addition to supplying our food, these four systems provide virtually all the raw materials for industry, except minerals and petroleum-derived synthetics. In large areas of the world, human claims on these systems are reaching an unsustainable level, a point where the productivity is being impaired. Okay, now, what are the main biological systems? What are the Earth's principal biological systems? We have fisheries, forest, grasslands, and croplands. Are the meaning of these words clear? What are grasslands? What are grasslands?
And they are fields of grasses, tall grasses.
Yeah, where basically the entire vegetation is dominated by the continuous cover of grasses. And what are croplands?
Ma'am, where food crop is grown.
Yeah, very good. The land used for growing crops. Very good. So they are the main principal biological system. Why? Because, see, they form the foundation of global economic system. When I say economic system, what is economic system? Or what is our economy? Economy is where the production of goods and services happen, right? The production and consumption of goods and services happen. So every time a good is produced, every time a good is produced or a service is used, they all from somewhere or the other come from these biological systems. Okay, they form the entire economic system. Now we use so many things, like we wear clothes, we eat food, so many essential requirements are there. Where do we get that from? From shops, and they get from the industries, and the industries get all of these from these systems, right? They get raw materials from these biological systems. Okay, so these are the four biological systems that provide raw materials to various industries, and then the final product reaches us. That is the entire economic system. Okay, so now when we know that these four biological systems are so essential to us, okay, that they are part and parcel of our lives, we know that this is so important, but what we do, we overuse them. Okay, we overuse them to such an extent that they are at a risk now. Okay, in large areas of the world, human claims on these systems are reaching an unsustainable level, a point where the productivity is being impaired. What is unsustainable? What do you mean by unsustainable?
Using crops and everything, fossil fuels in present and not.
Very good.
Depleting.
Depleting, which cannot be safe, which cannot be sustained. Okay, which are not being maintained. Yeah, very good. Just hold on a second. Okay. Now, so now we have used them in such a way that humans have claimed on these systems at this level that they have reached to an unsustainable level, that they are not being maintained at a rate that it should be maintained, right? Okay. When this happens, fisheries collapse, forests disappear, grasslands are converted into barren wastelands, and croplands deteriorate. In a protein-conscious and protein-hungry world, overfishing is common every day. In poor countries, local forests are being decimated in order to procure firewood for cooking. In some places, firewood has become so expensive that what goes under the pot now costs more than what goes inside it. Since the tropical forest is, in the words of Dr. Myers, the powerhouse of evolution, several species of life face extinction as a result of its destruction. Now what happens is that, why is tropical forest called as the powerhouse of evolution? Why is the tropical forest called as the powerhouse of evolution? It is just because several of the species, they depend on these forests for their survival. Okay? And if these forests are extinct, what will happen? First of all, their lives will be endangered. Okay, and second of all, the ecological balance of the world will suffer. Okay, and now what are we doing to these forests? We are killing it. That is what decimated means. Decimated means to kill it. Okay, so we are killing it just so we can provide for ourselves. Okay, so in order to procure firewood for cooking. So firewood has become so expensive that what goes under the pot, what goes under the pot means that the pot is boiling, the pot is making the food. What is there under the pot? It is the firewood that is used for cooking the food inside the pot. So that firewood has become so much expensive, much more expensive than the food inside the pot. Clear? Okay. Why do you think the firewood has become so expensive? Because
Because of so much deforestation and there are many trees left.
Yeah, because so much deforestation is happening, so much killing of forest, killing of trees are happening, that when you go and sell that firewood, you will sell it more expensive. Because you know what happens behind it is that you kill a tree. You cut a tree. Okay? It has been well said that forests precede mankind, deserts follow. Okay, now this is very important. What does forest precede mankind? And then deserts follow. Forest precede mankind means that forest came much before the before the existence of mankind. Okay. How do I remove all of this? Okay. Forest precede mankind, yes, deserts follow. Okay, forest precede mankind, deserts follow means that forest came much before the existence of mankind. Okay, and what is mankind doing? Mankind is killing the forest and they are converting them to deserts. Is that clear? Yeah. So it's like first forest ki, and then the mankind. And then what is the mankind doing to the forest? They are converting into desert. Okay. How are they doing this? How are they doing this?
By deforestation.
By deforestation. By converting the grasslands into barren wastelands. Okay. By this, they are converting it into deserts. Is that clear? Is this line clear? Forests precede mankind and deserts follow. Okay, very good. Okay. Okay, see now. So what we have learned till now in this paragraph, first of all, that we have four biological system, four principal biological system. We have fisheries, we have forests, we have grasslands, and then we have croplands. Okay, and what do? They form the foundation of the global economic system. How do they form the foundation of the global economic system? That first of all, they supply our food, they provide us with food. And not only that, they also provide raw materials for the industries from where we get the final products, okay? And we are overusing it in such a way that their productivity is being impaired, okay? That their productivity is being impaired means that they are not able to produce for us as much as they should. Okay, because nature is there to provide us. But if we misuse it, even nature becomes helpless. Okay, and when you overuse it and it reaches an unsustainable level, what happens that fisheries will collapse. Okay, forests will disappear and grasslands will convert into barren wastelands and croplands will also decline. Clear? Okay, now one thing I want to tell all of you is that first of all, you need to make projects. Okay, you need to make projects. How will you make projects? That you will make a group of 5 to 6 students. Okay, is everyone listening?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes,
okay.
Yes,
ma'am. You have to make projects and by making a group into 5 to 6 students. Okay. And in that, the project should be a collaborative research. Okay. In a group, but the files that will be made will be individual files. Clear? So you can do the research together. Okay. But the files will be individual files. Clear? And the last date for this will be submitting for this will be January 5. And the topics are Green Movement and its history so far. Sustainable development. Okay. Role and responsibility of science and technology in green movement success. Role of industries in implementing the green movement. Yeah, so I'll be sending these topics in the group also. Don't worry. I'm just reading it out. Okay. India and its green movement, Indian forest and rivers purification project, and how we are still to catch up with green countries. Okay. How India is still lacking behind. So once we read this chapter, once we complete this chapter, you will have a more clear idea as when we read the chapter forward. Okay. We'll need more consequences of all the human activities. Okay. So you'll have a much clearer idea. Who can tell me the green countries? This is very easy. Who can tell me the green, who can tell me the name of green countries? Okay. And you,
ma'am, okay, are these those countries which have a lot of green cover?
Yeah, which have a lot of, basically their environment is still sustainable. So we have Brazil, we have Australia, we have Austria, we have, I guess, Belgium also. Iceland is there, Iceland is there, Finland is there, France is there, Greece.
America. I'm Brazil.
Brazil is there. Good. Okay, so these are green countries. Okay. Italy is also there. Okay. So now you have to write why India is lagging behind and how we as Indians can, you know, reach that level. Okay. So is the project idea clear? Okay. It should be a collaborative research. Okay. But the files will be individual. Make a group of 6 to 7. You can make a group of 6 to 7. Since you have a lot of strength in this class, make a group of 6 to 7. Okay. And do just message me that what teams have you made. Okay. What groups have you made? Okay. Write the group and just write the students' names. Okay. And make a collaborative research, make individual files, and the last date is January 5, after your winter vacation. Any doubt?
And what should be the
topics that I, length can be 8 to 10 pages. Make it short only. 8 to 10 pages is enough. Okay, 8 to 10 pages is enough. And I'll be sending you a list of topics that I just read out. And you can select any topic you wish to make a project on. Any doubt now?
8 to 10 pages will be, ma'am, will we have to make individually or in a group?
Individually. The files will be made individually. 8 to 10 pages in a file.
Ma'am, then can we share the same file? Like for all, everyone can share the same file.
Not same file, obviously. Two different things. You can draw pictures, or you can paste different things. Just the research can be the same. The research can be the same. The statistics that you use in your project, that can be the same. That can be same. Okay. So
okay,
project, the research can be same, but paste different pictures. Write different things. Your opinion can be different, okay, from your teammates, okay? So make sure all of that is different. If you don't want to do 8 to 10 pages is enough, right? You can do till 7, but do not do less than 7 pages, please.
Ma'am, okay, can you please message all the instructions as a message?
Yeah, I'll send that. I'll send that in the group. Okay, clear? Just in case of any doubt, you can talk to me, okay? And we'll continue tomorrow. Okay?
Thank you.
Okay, bye. Take care.
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay.
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay, bye.